Apple's got brand new MacBook Airs launching this week, and I have both the 13 and 15 inch models in for testing. So let's talk about the five big changes that you'll find here on the new M3 MacBook Air when compared to the M2 models. And let's jump into an unboxing while I tell you about them. First, of course, is the M3 chip, which originally debuted in October in the iMac. What does upgrading to an M3 chip actually mean for you? Think about the times you've been working on a project and your current laptop just couldn't keep up. If you're still using an Intel-based Mac, you might know exactly what I mean. The M3 chip delivers up to 20% faster CPU performance compared to the M2, 60% faster than the M1, and up to 13 times faster than the fastest Intel-based MacBook Air. In real terms, this means your apps not only launch faster, but run smoother, even and especially when you're juggling multiple tasks at once. For me, I found the M2 MacBook Air to be already plenty fast enough, and I'm really glad that Apple has dropped the price of that model and kept it in the lineup. But where the M3 gets more interesting for me is that it isn't just a 20% bump in speed. Apple has also integrated hardware accelerated ray tracing in the M3 series of chips for the first time, enhancing the graphics rendering in games and professional applications. Now, this is a big deal because it's about bringing more immersive visuals directly to your laptop without the need for external hardware. So your gaming and visual content creation experiences are about to get a significant upgrade, immersing you in stunningly realistic graphics. And if you're into gaming, you've seen how these big AAA titles have been making their way to the Mac, and the fact that they can play games like Death Stranding and Resident Evil 4 at this quality on Apple's entry-level laptop is awesome. Throw a controller in your backpack and the M3 MacBook Air can be your portable gaming machine on top of everything else it offers. Also, if you're into streaming video content, the addition of hardware AV1 video decoding on the M3 means you can expect better video quality with less buffering. AI applications are all the rage right now, and Apple has recognized this too, calling the MacBook Air the world's best consumer laptop for AI. This is due to the faster and more efficient neural engine on the M3, sporting 16 cores, which allows apps to take advantage of local AI features to run even faster. That means things like enhancing photos in Pixelmator Pro, or doing live transcription in Mac Whisper, which I do a lot, or even running local LLMs and diffusion models for text and image generation will just fly. Now, the next big feature we need to talk about is the MacBook Air now supports using two external displays at once. This is a feature that's been highly requested by users for years, just for the enhanced productivity and multitasking capabilities. Previously, MacBook Airs running the M1 and M2 Apple Silicon chips could only officially support one external display. Now, with the lid open, you can connect one external display up to 6K resolution at 60 Hertz while still using the display of the laptop itself. Closing the lid allows for a second external display at up to 5K resolution at 60 Hertz. I personally tested this and it works as advertised, as you can see here. And if you're curious what happens when running two external displays and then you open the lid back up, well, one of the displays will simply turn off, as you see here. Being able to use a MacBook Air to power two external displays is a very nice addition to the product, but just keep in mind, since you have to have the lid closed, you are gonna need an external keyboard, mouse, and/or trackpad in order to keep using the Mac. Now, additionally, for those who require even more screen real estate, DisplayLink adapters can be used to connect additional displays, further expanding the MacBook Air's versatility without sacrificing performance. Another way the M3 MacBook Air is getting even faster is with Wi-Fi 6E support. Wi-Fi 6E extends the capabilities of Wi-Fi 6 into the 6 GHz band, offering users up to twice as fast wireless download speeds compared to the previous models with Wi-Fi 6. Now for me, this is crucial for streaming high definition content, engaging in online gaming without lag, ensuring smooth video calls, as well as quickly uploading large files like this video, for instance. For the average user, it translates to more reliable connections and the ability to handle multiple high bandwidth activities simultaneously without a hitch. For tech enthusiasts and professionals, it's about unlocking the potential of their internet service, allowing for quicker uploads, downloads, and seamless syncing of large files. I have a Wi-Fi 7 network here in my home. I'll link what I'm using down below if you want to check it out. And I can tell you, that even for devices running Wi-Fi 6E, you see a really nice speed increase when compared to Wi-Fi 6, just due to the inclusion of support for that 6 gigahertz band. Up next, the M3 MacBook Air also has better microphones. In the realm of digital communication, clarity is king. You want to know that your voice comes through crisply and clearly, whether you're on a video call, recording a podcast, or giving a virtual presentation. The M3 MacBook Air sports a 3-mic array with directional beamforming, alongside new voice isolation and wide spectrum microphone modes. Voice isolation mode is designed to minimize background noise, focusing the microphone's attention solely on your voice. This means that even if you're in a bustling coffee shop or a windy outdoor environment, people listening to you will hear just your voice without all that noise around you. Now, on the flip side, wide spectrum mode embraces the environment, capturing your voice and the surrounding sounds with equal fidelity. So this mode is perfect for those who want to convey a sense of place or presence in their recordings or need to share the ambiance of their surroundings during a call. Both of these features can also thank that neural engine on the M3 chip for their existence. All right, this next feature is for all of my midnight lovers out there. I admit that when it comes to colors on Apple's laptops, I'm all about the darkest ones because they just look so stealthy. On the MacBook Pro, that means space black, and here on the MacBook Air, it's midnight. Now, the problem with the midnight color on the M2 was that it was an absolute fingerprint magnet. You can even see right there. Fingerprint magnet. It wasn't enough to deter me from that color, but I know that there were some who chose something different because of this. Well, now, similar to what Apple did on the space black MacBook Pro, the M3 MacBook Air has a new anodization seal to reduce fingerprints on this sleek midnight finish. And you do not see any fingerprints anywhere. Like, I can touch it, I can rub my fingers on it, like, it looks totally fine. Doing that same thing on the M2, you would see an instant change. In fact, I have an M2 MacBook Air here next to the M3 for comparison, and I think that seal does a great job at keeping the surface free from smudges and fingerprints. And yes, I get that to some, this feature may seem small in the grand scheme of things, especially if you're buying a MacBook Air in one of the other three colors, those being silver, space gray, and starlight, which I happen to have here in the 15-inch model. But it's these thoughtful touches that contribute to the overall appeal of Apple's approach to its products. Whether you're in a professional setting or presenting to clients or just using your device at home, the fingerprint-resistant midnight color ensures that your MacBook Air remains as visually impressive as its performance. Oh, and if you're deciding between the 13 and 15-inch models, aside from the obvious difference in screen size, the larger version also sports a 6-speaker sound system with force-canceling woofers compared to the 4-speaker array with no woofers on the smaller MacBook Air. Now, real quick, I want to extend a heartfelt thank you for the incredible support you guys have shown me on my recent Apple Vision Pro review video. Your comments and feedback always make this journey worthwhile. For those who haven't seen it, I highly recommend checking it out. I will leave a link down in the description below. A full review on the M3 MacBook Air is coming, but for now, thanks for watching. As always, guys, I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Edwards, and I will catch you in the next video.